Hey guys, Patrick here at JTech. Today we're going to be showing you how to do a static compression test. So first what we're going to want to do, we want to come up here, take this retaining nut off of a coil pack, set this up here so we don't lose it. We're going to disconnect the wiring from the coil pack and take that out. Next we're going to want to take out the spark plug. So what we got here is we got a gauge here, and we have a hose here that has multiple adapters, these multiple hoses. Set them right down inside of there where the spark plug goes, and you're going to screw it in hand tight. We do that because it has a rubber O-ring on there. And make sure that this is set to zero. You're going to plug this up. And you're going to want to watch for 5 ticks on here, 5 jumps. And we have Beth inside to do so. Beth, can you rub it, do it? Yep. Good. And reading right around 150, a few below, maybe 148, 149. That's a little bit below spec. Usually it runs between 165 and 185. And it's a good indicator that lets us know that it's not. There might be a little bit of some worn rings around it. The valves might be a little bit worn. Do that on all 4 of them. Usually you'd have all 4 of the spark plugs removed, have them out, your button there to release it. And you do that, you'd go through all of them, and then you'd go back through and do a wet compression test on all of them, see if it can help seal up some of the rings. And that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and see you next in the video.